In this tutorial, we'll take a look at how to multiply cells in Excel, as well as learn when and how to fix cells in our formulas to give us the desired result. Hey, what's up? Chad here with Determined Data, helping you organize and manage your information in the most efficient way possible. If you're new here, on this channel, I do Excel tips and tricks videos as well as tutorials just like this one. So if you find it helpful, consider subscribing. So I have here some data here for a senior class fundraiser. I have some students, and let's just say they're selling, I don't know, a box of specialty donuts or calendars or something like that. I have here some basic information about it, like the cost per unit and the selling price. And what we want to do is find the net profit for each student and then calculate it all. To find the net profit though, we need to know our cost of goods and our gross profit. So we're going to need to multiply some numbers together here to get that information. So let's start with our cost of goods. Now, cost of goods sold is basically just the cost of sales. So how much did it cost us to buy all these units? Now to calculate that, we need to start our formula with an equal sign. Click on our cell we want to multiply, and then the multiplication symbol in Excel is the asterisk. So asterisk, and then multiply that by the cost per unit. And we hit enter. And there we have our cost of goods for Donna. She bought 20 and it costs at $650 per unit, it cost her $130. Now, we want to copy this formula all the way down, but watch what happens when I try to do that. I grab here in the right lower right-hand corner and I drag down, and I get zeros for all the ones below. Now, that happened because if I click into this cell, as you can see here, it's referencing H9 when I really wanted to reference H8. And again, if I click down here into this cell, it's referencing all the way down here, and I don't want that. I want it to reference H8. To fix this, we need to fix our cell in our formula. So we'll go back to this cell, we'll delete it, and we'll start over here. So we'll start with the equal sign, and then we'll click on this, multiply, and then hit this. Now, we want to fix this cell so that every single cell that we copy this formula to references H8. To do that, we need to put dollar signs in front of the H and the 8. And now when I copy this formula down, it gives me the correct values because it's referencing the correct cell. And again, if I come down here, you can see it's still referencing H8. So now that we have our cost of goods, let's go ahead and calculate our gross. Hit equal sign to start our formula. And this time we want to multiply how many units we sold times our selling price. And again, we want to fix this number by putting dollar signs in front of it. And there we have our gross. And now let's copy down this formula. And Excel will automatically populate those values for us. Now we have our cost of goods, our gross, and now we can finally do our net profit. Again, we'll start our formula with an equal sign. And now we don't need to multiply anything. We just need to subtract cost of goods from our gross. So we'll click on this, minus cost of goods. This time we don't want to fix anything because we want the cells below to reference the cells directly to the left. So we'll go ahead and hit enter and drag that formula down. And there we have it. And we, as you can see, some of the students did not make a profit at all, and that is represented by the parentheses around the number here, which indicates that it's negative. So there you have some examples of some basic multiplication between cells in Excel. In the next video, we'll go over some simple formatting and how to add data bars to our net profit information here to make this data set and spreadsheet more readable and easier to understand. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please like it and subscribe for more content.